Yes.
We have come to rock you tonight. Close your eyes. Why am I getting a feeling like we're going to have a good time tonight? Now, sometimes you record a song, then you do the vocal, and the record's mixed and it goes up on a shelf. And if you're not touring, you never do that song again. This next song we're going to do is a song that until this year I had never done live. I'm going to do it for you. It's getting better on the ride.
Getting better,
Great for us, this is the second leg of our US tour. It's great to be here for the first time in Hartford. We've been practicing and stuff, so we've just been itching to get at an audience like you. So let's boogie woogie!
Thank you.
Can you hear okay up at the back? Okay, all the songs so far have been old songs, and this is a new song. It's off our new album. It's like this. A new album out in California, and we got one day off in the middle of the recording, and so we thought, oh, it's going to be great weather, California. We looked out the studio, it was like pouring rain. Okay, doesn't matter, day off. So I took a drive up the Pacific Coast Highway, a little black Corvette, radio on. We had a great day anyway, and when we got back to the house, I came up with this next song, which is the title of that new album, Driving Rain. Connecticut. Communications. All right. At this point, I would like to introduce our exceptional, extremely bodacious drummer man, Mr. Abe Laborio Jr. Hello, Connecticut. You guys rock. It's really good to be here. Really good to see you all. And now for more rock.
Are you ready to
rock? I'm ready. I'd like to do this next song, especially for someone very special in the audience tonight. This song is for my beautiful lady, Heather. My old lady.
Thank you.
And this is the portion of the show where they all go away and leave me all alone with you. And I can handle it if you can. Next song I'm going to do was written in the 60s. Around about that time, there was a lot of troubles going on, particularly in the southern states in America with civil rights, and we were hearing about it over in England. And in England, sometimes we call girls birds. You know that. We sometimes call them other things too. Anyway, so I was imagining the plight of a young black woman and her struggles at that time. I came up with this song, and I blew out my mind. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly. All your life you were only waiting for this moment to arise. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these sunken eyes and learn to see. All your life you were only waiting for this moment to be free. Blackbird fly. Blackbird. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly. All your life you were only waiting for this moment to rise. Blackbird fly. Singing in the dead of night. Won't you take these sunken eyes and learn to see. All your life you were only waiting for this moment to be free. You were only waiting for this moment to be free. You were only waiting for this moment to be free. Every night I just wanna go out, get out of my head. Every day I don't wanna get up, get out of my bed. Every night I wanna play out, and every day I wanna do, ooh, 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 ooh. But tonight I just wanna stay and be with you. day I lean on a lamppost, I'm wasting my time. Every night I lay on a pillow, just resting my mind. Every morning brings a new day, and every night that day is through. Ooh, 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 ooh. But tonight I just wanna stay in and be with you. warned this guy about his overuse of steroids. Time for your massage. Don't be close to me. Now, one of the great things about being on tour, though, besides the great audiences and the great band and really enjoying playing, one of the other great things is you get to get a lot of massages. It's true, because you go to all these hotels around the country, around the world, you can always get a massage. And mainly, you know, they're great. Yeah, great massages, but I have had one or two very dodgy massages. That's true. true. True story. I mean, I should probably write a book, Massages I Have Known. True story. This. I was in New Orleans, and in a hotel, so I got a little massage, and the bloke comes up, and he's quite a thick-set fella, and he gets his table out, and then he says to me, "Please sit upright on the table." So I'm sitting upright on the table. He says, "I'd like you to imagine that your leg is hollow and made of bronze." Then a little bit later, he says, "I'd like you to imagine that your neck is like a giraffe's neck." So I'm a little bit worried here. He says, "How do you feel?" I said, "I feel like a giraffe with a hollow bronze leg." That's true. And then at the end of the session, he says, "Sit upright on the table again." He says, "I want you to look into my eyes with your eyes and try and burn a hole in my eyes with your eyes." And I'm thinking, you know, I want a massage, not a relationship. And then another time, another massage I have known was when I was in Tokyo on tour. No, not that time. In this hotel, and I'd ordered a massage. This little lady comes up and she says, "Please lie on floor on towel." Okay. So I'm lying on the floor on the towel and she starts massaging me. And then I just suddenly hear, "Yes, Daddy, on my 12 Luckily, she didn't know the middle eight, so it didn't go on too long. That's a true story. Would I lie to you? Day after day, alone on a hill, a man with a foolish grin is keeping perfectly still. And nobody wants to know. Just a fool, and he never gives an answer. But the fool on the hill sees the sun going down, and the eyes in his head see the world spinning around. And on the way, his head in a cloud, a man of a thousand voices talking perfectly loud, but nobody ever hears him. As if he's mad, and he never seems to notice. But the fool on the hill sees the sun going down, and the eyes in his head see the world spinning round. Thank you. you very much. Well, thank you, lovely audience. Thanks. I think sometimes in life it's difficult to say to people just what you mean to say. Sometimes you mean to say something and then you don't get the opportunity or you haven't got the courage. And I think it's particularly sad if somebody passes away and then you think, oh, I wish I'd said that, I wish I'd told them that. And sometimes you just don't do it, you don't have the opportunity. And this next song is one that I wrote after my dear friend John passed away. Let's hear it for John. It's in the form of an imaginary conversation between me and him. And if I said I really knew you well, what would your answer be? If you were here today, George was a really fine ukulele player. He he was a big fan of a guy in Britain called George Formby. He was a black and white film star, comedian of the 1940s. And George was actually such a big fan, he was in his fan club. And he used to go up to the annual convention up in that little place up in the north called Blackpool. And there'd be about 50 of these guys, including George, all sitting around. You knew all the songs you played, it was great though, I must say. Anyway, what would happen would be if you went round to George's house to have something to eat, after dinner, the ukuleles would come out, he had a big collection. Would you like a ukulele? Would you like to play? And we'd all sit around playing ukuleles, you know, he loved it so much. And actually, he gave me this one. And so one night I was sitting there with him, and I said, I do a little song on ukulele, because I'd had one for a while, too. And I wasn't in the fan club. So I said, I do a song, and I played it for him, I'd like to play it for you tonight as a tribute to George. Something in the way she moved attracts me like no other lover. Something in the way she moves me, I don't want to leave her now. Well, you know I believe her now. Somewhere in a smile she I don't need no other lover. Something in a style that shows me I don't want to leave you now. Well, you know I believe in now. So George listens to me doing this, he listens to me, he says, no. He says, no, it doesn't go like that. So it goes like this. Something in the way she moves attracts me, I know. John said to me, you remember that, like, that mad French stuff you used to do at the parties? He said, well, it was one of them quite good, you know. He said, we should do that. So we did. We did.
Oh,
stuck inside these four walls, set inside forever, never seeing no one. Nice again. You. Okay, playing that blistering solo on that last song is our fantastic guitar player, Rusty Anderson.
I'll tell you what it's like up here. It's so much fun. You guys feeling all right? It smells like you're feeling all right to me. Here's Paul Pien.
Maybe I'm afraid of the way I love you.
tonight, you're going to do it for all the lovers in the house. And you know who you are. It's just for you. Introduce you properly to our lovable, delightful, delicious keyboard player, Paul Wicks Wicked. Thank you very much.
That's really an utterly good job. I love it. I get to play.
play a bit of accordion, I can play some piano, some organ, some lovely brass parts, some lovely string parts, many and various things. And this next song, I think, has one of the coolest string parts that was ever written for a pop song on it. It's also another of the songs that has not been done since Paul recorded. So, you're one of the very first few people to hear it live on your podcast.
Thank you.
Actually, that song goes back quite a few years. Oh, yeah. This next one doesn't, though. This is a song that we wrote last year, especially for the concert for New York. We'd like you to join in with this one. Let's see you clapping those hands like this. Playing bass and guitar and singing all evening. This is the incomparable Brian Ray.
Oh, hi, Brian. You feel good?
Oh, you sound great.
Listen, I don't know if you got this memo, but on the next song, we're going to do a little something special. We're going to have marshmallow roasting. So I hope you all brought some sticks and some marshmallows and some s'mores, and you'll see why in just a minute. Back to Paul.
When you were young and your heart wasn't open for
Thank you. Thank you for the light. Shout out to tomorrow. Very cool. Thank you. Now you're a grand bunch of people tonight. On this next song, there's a bit, particularly at the end, that I think you might want to join in with. And if you do, feel free.
Baby face, you got the no.
It's not there. It's a good one. It's not there.
Hey, Jude. Hey, Jude, don't be afraid.
you want to keep on rocking. And I get the feeling you've got even more energy left. In that case, 1, 2, 3, 4! But you were just 17. Thank you.
Sergeant Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band.
you.